If not for time, mankind would be nothing but dreamers. Time brings both the end and the new. Over the past few weeks, I have been thinking about the concept of time. As our years in high school draw to an end, it seems that time is all that matters. Really, we've centered the last 12 years of our lives around it. Time to get up, time to get to school, time for practice, time for work, time for homework, time to sleep, and then repeat endlessly. I've tried to relate the concept to our 4 years at St. Albans High School. How has time affected us? Well, we have endured classes where we had to bide our time until the bell finally rang. When we put off our schoolwork until the last minute, as some were known to do, we were in crunch time. Far too often, we completed our projects just in the nick of time. And when we didn't, we tried to buy more time from our teachers. And only sometimes did that work. Even our social lives were ruled by time. We enjoyed our first times. We congregated behind the bleachers or in the end zone at halftime. We chatted with each other on FaceTime. Some couples withstood the test of time, while others were too busy two-timing. Time flew on the weekends. Will we miss our friends when we leave for college? All the time. After graduation, we know that many of our classmates will have the drive and ambition to succeed. A few will hit the big time. Look around you. Who will they be? Others aren't certain where they want to go in life. They may await the day when a road to their future reveals itself. Where will we be in 5, 10, 20 years from now? Only time will tell. To our teachers, counselors, and administration, thank you for taking the time to prepare us for whatever life will bring us after high school. We appreciate your dedication and enthusiasm, and we know you will continue to inspire the students of St. Albans High School to reach for the stars. Your work is often thankless, and it's high time we express our appreciation. To our parents and families, we couldn't be here without you tonight. Thank you for the love and support that you've provided when we were difficult. We may have accused you now and then of being behind the times, but truly, your experience and advice hand-shaped us into the young adults stand before you today. I'm sure there were occasions when you doubted that any of us might survive the terrible teens, but time works wonders. We have become more responsible and mature than many of us ever imagined. To my classmates, consider this. The years, months, hours, and minutes, the past, has in this moment become the now. We now have the ability to reach our goals through dedication, determination, perseverance. We have spent years talking about all the things we think adults have done wrong. Now, we are the adults, and we can bring change, both to our own lives and to this country that we love. We do not have to accept status quo. It's high time we accept responsibility to shape the future for ourselves and for our future families. Time is of the essence, but it is on our side. I have so much more I would like to say to each of you. But it's time to hit the road. But I would like to leave with a few words from a wise and great philosopher from our childhood, the eminent Dr. Seuss, who asked a question about time that we all tonight are probably asking ourselves. How did it get so late so soon? It's night before it's afternoon. December is here before it's June. My goodness, how the time has flown. How did it get so late so soon? The doctor is always right. Time has flown. It is late. Our childhoods have passed, the hours have rushed by, and tomorrow is knocking at the door. When we open that door, let's do so without fear, without hesitation, and without looking back. Class of 2017, believe me when I tell you, the time is now.